बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। थैंक यू वेरी मच प्राइम फॉर इनवाइटिंग एंड इट्स रियली इम्प्रेसिव एंड लॉट ऑफ इंटेलेक्चुअल्स दे आर सिटिंग हियर एंड आई एम फीलिंग वेरी ऑनर्ड एंड प्रिविलेज टू बी द पार्ट ऑफ दिस प्राइम कॉन्फ्रेंस। ओके, द टास्क इज गिवन टू मी, व्हाट इज माय टेक ऑन टैक्सेशन इन पाकिस्तान and how it is working, whether it is efficient or what is happening to the tax side of the country. Let me tell you one thing, our tax to GDP is hovering between 9 to 11%. In good particular year, when we don't have big devaluation etc., so our tax to GDP crosses 10%. When there is high inflation and you know our tax target remains same, even if we meet the tax targets, our tax to GDP is below 10%, which is not sufficient at all. Because whatever the tax collected by federal government, 58.5% goes back to provinces. Only 41.5% left with the federal government, and they have to run their entire government, they have to pay back their debts, etc., etc. So there are two questions. A is whether you know federal government need to reduce the provincial transfers or they have to increase the pie. Usually, you know, when we struggle with the fiscal side, people, including myself in the past, we used to say this, you know, federal government should cut down the provincial share just to ensure fiscal deficit remain under control. But when I joined this provincial government, I came to know that all provincial governments, they are relying on federal receipts between 75 to 95%. So you know, if there will be a single percentage point drop in provincial transfers, even the bigger province like Punjab will struggle. So that is not the case. You know, we should not go for that. Secondly, you know, the other point, what is provinces doing on their own tax receipts? We made them lazy, we gave them money, they have been spending, actually not investing, they have been spending you know, mostly politically. Just to tell you about my province, we have approximately 700,000 people employed with the provincial government, which is huge compared to the population size, which is 45 million. In the past few years, especially after 18 amendment, the government is, you know, more focused on giving jobs and, you know, building their political capital. It's not just KP, it's everywhere, Punjab, etc., etc. So now their expenditure have, you know, gone up, and especially the current expenditure, there is very little money left for the development side. Can we reverse these employments? No, because our structure is very rigid. If once you have employed anyone, you cannot force them to retire or leave, or you cannot fire them. So whatever the way forward is only the way forward. You cannot go into history. So provinces must focus on their tax mobilization. At the same time, federal government, you know, they have to broaden their tax net, for example. They have to increase the footprint in retail and wholesale sector. They have to increase their footprint in this real estate sector. Provincial government, now the domain of agriculture sector is with provincial government. I'm sure majority of the people you know, this year 12,970 billion every year tax collection target is, and total agriculture tax collection is less than 5 billion rupees by all provinces. So if you compare the size of GDP, size of agriculture in GDP is almost 20%, but 0.2% even in overall tax collection, the agriculture taxes is not there. So, you know, provinces have to work very hard. If you want to make this country sustainable, you have to make it sustainable from the provinces side. KP, unfortunately, we are not too big in agriculture, so we can't do much in agriculture side. But still, we have signed the fiscal pact with IMF, and one of the major reform in the fiscal pact is AIT, Agriculture Income Tax. So let's see, you know, Punjab or Sindh will come up to the curve. What we have done, because in the interest of time, I'll wrap up in 2 minutes. What we have done on the tax mobilization side, provinces have to focus more on the non-tax side. Tax, majority of the taxes is with federal government, for example, custom duties, income tax, sales tax, excise duties. What is left with provincial government is A, agriculture tax, B, property tax, which is non-tax revenue. And the other taxes, what are those other taxes and which can contribute significantly? In KP, we have increased the cess rate by 400% on tobacco, for example. Tobacco is the key crop in KP. We have introduced the infrastructure development cess on Afghan trade transit, export and import, which is traveling back and forth from KP to the borders. We have, in fact, reduced the property tax. And I just came out from the IMF meeting. I told them, you know, since you have increased the rate of property, the tax collection have reduced by 70%, at least in my province case. Because now the net transaction cost of real estate for the ninth filer is 23%, including all federal and provincial taxes. So now people, they are just doing the bilateral agreement and they are not going for the registry and the mutation. So as a result of it, my revenues have reduced by 70% because of this. So I told them there are two sides of the taxpayers. One is non-filer and the other one is filer. In non-filer, there are another two type of people. One is you know, rich people, another one is poor people. KP is, you know, population, more than 50% of the population of KP is poor. And their ticket sizes, they are, you know, they're just cook, driver, you know, guard, security guard. So they will remain non-filer for life. And their ticket size, if they buy property, between $5,000 to $10,000. And if you're charging 22-23% on transfer, they cannot afford it. So then they will go for the bilateral agreement. So what you need to do is, you have to segregate it with the ticket size. Anything below $10,000 or $15,000, they should not be paying, you know, 12.5% withholding tax on the transaction. Yes, I don't mind, you know, increase it to 20% for the rich people who are doing, you know, $1,000, $100,000 property transaction or sector, sector. I have been keep on saying this to IMF, to the federal government, but for the optics sake, you know, they are doing it, and actually it is discouraging the documentation. So we have done a lot of reforms. We have introduced 50 tax reforms in the last money bill, and as a result of it, our tax revenue receipts increased by 31%. Just to conclude, KP have produced 103 billion rupees fiscal surplus for the first quarter. Our target was 45 billion rupees. We are on the sweetest spot of the, at least in the last 15 years, or I can claim that in the last 77 years in terms of cash balances. So we are much more prudent. We are adopting, we have been adopting three policies: revenue maximization, expenditure rationalization, and maximum resource mobilization. And so far it has been working. Thank you very much.